Christian Audio, a division of Recorded Books, presents Walking the Way of Harriet Tubman, Public Mystic and Freedom Fighter by Therese Taylor-Stinson, narrated by Lisa Reneé Pitts. Forward, leading from within. Always remember, you have within you the strength, the patience, and the passion to reach for the stars to change the world. Meme popularly attributed to Tubman, unsourced. There is within the human spirit a source of renewal, courage, and ingenuity that equips us to fulfill our purpose here on Earth. Howard Thurman refers to this powerful interiority as the sound of the genuine within. This deeply contemplative wellspring strengthens both individuals and entire communities as they seek freedom. However, seeking freedom is one thing. Obtaining freedom is quite another. If freedom was a stationary goal, we would have reached it long ago. Therese Taylor-Stinson in Walking the Way of Harriet Tubman, Public Mystic and Freedom Fighter, reminds us that freedom is a spiritual state of being that shapeshifts from generation to generation. Those who lead us toward that elusive state of being must also be led by spirit. We have known Harriet Tubman as a freedom fighter and abolitionist, whose exploits and courage are highlighted every Black History Month. Taylor Stinson affirms Tubman's status as a freedom fighter, but awakens us to her role as a public mystic and spiritual exemplar. When I was growing up, most of the mystics that I was introduced to were of European lineage, although their messages of faith, personal salvation, and the love of God continue to bless me to this day. I needed more. I needed leadership that lifted and protected the community. I wanted to see women and men who looked like me leading freedom's charge. This book fulfills that need. In Joy Unspeakable, I refer to public mystics as leaders who embody the ineffable while attending to the ordinary, those who host the transcendent, the mystical, and the mundane while engaged in pragmatic justice-seeking acts. Public mystics are peculiar people. Harriet was no exception. With her brain injury, she had an additional weight of struggles, but trusted in God. God brought visions in the trances that resulted from the injury, pointing her to safety and freedom. Whether you are leading escaping Africans toward the Ohio River or filming the murder of George Floyd in real time, you are relying upon the Divine One and not your own resources to sustain and protect you. But what does that mean? It may mean that in times of trouble, we enter the fray led by choirs and public mystics rather than the military, and that we rely on a living God for ultimate outcomes. So where are the public mystics when you need them most? I see them in the peaceful resistance of another generation of freedom fighters. They are with us in the stories told and retold of lives well lived. They are in our prophetic imaginations as we welcome Harriet into our present reality. Her counterintuitive leadership, empowered by dreams and trances, confronts the delusion of empires that they have ultimate control. As renowned biblical scholar Walter F. Brueggemann often said during Old Testament theology classes, God has other ideas about that. If we are willing to follow unlikely leaders, public mystics, and a crucified Messiah from the hood, can anything good come out of Nazareth? John chapter 1, verse 46. if we are willing to forsake the managed reality of empire, then anything is possible. Harriet Tubman speaks into our lives through the particularities of her own suffering as an African-American woman born into slavery and the oppression of her community. But she is no longer confined by racial mythologies to one community or another. Instead, she bears witness that spiritual freedom is possible for all who are marginalized and oppressed. Can't you see her? I can see her now, small of stature, big of heart, running for free. She is running past her fears and ours, her exhaustion and ours. As she traverses rivers to avoid the slave hunters and dogs, she keeps an eye on the North Star and reflects on the wonder of the creator / creatrix. Although she dies of natural causes in peace and a modicum of freedom, in my mind's eye, she is running still, encouraging us, all of us, to go on and see what the end is going to be. Reverend Barbara A. Holmes, J.D., Ph.D., President Emerita, United Theological Seminary of the Twin Cities, Core Faculty, Center for Action and Contemplation. Prologue. As I stood on the bank of the Choptank River in Dorchester County, Maryland, one early spring afternoon, in a single line across the sand with other pilgrims on this Tubman journey, I was in awe of the flickers of light reflecting off the water from the noonday sun, holding sweet gum pods in our bare hands, reflecting on the joy and pain the enslaved endured. We imagined them running barefoot with the abundance of sweet gum under their feet. Through the woods to the river, Harriet was leading them to freedom. We walked to the bank of the river and poured libation as we named our personal ancestors, Mama Harriet, among them. Then we fell silent. In that silence, the wind picked up strength, blowing a soft but forceful presence in our direction. I couldn't help but believe that Harriet and others we named were before us, welcoming our presence. Slowly, the forceful breeze ceased. I turned with wide eyes to our guide, who stood next to me, and he nodded confirmation. No words, but he knew, and I knew, we had been visited by our ancestors. This was a mystical experience I will never forget. Now, even closer to me, are Mama Harriet and her treks to freedom. From childhood to adulthood, as she blended the indigenous mystical traditions passed down through her African ancestors with her Christian faith, Harriet Tubman's spiritual development throughout her life was primary to her becoming and making her worthy of the title mystic. By mystic, I mean a person who dwells mentally and internally in the spiritual realm. One who seeks by contemplation and self-surrender unity with the divine, and who believes in and adheres to the spiritual apprehension of truths whose source is beyond mere intellect. There are hardly any Black Americans formally named as mystics, but a few across history include Sojourner Truth, Jerena Lee, Zora Neale Hurston, Toni Morrison, Alice Walker, Howard Thurman, Martin Luther King Jr., Jeremiah Wright, William Barber, Tracy Blackman, and I am sure a host of unnamed and perhaps unknown others. Malcolm X is one I would identify as an Islamic public mystic. None, however, rise to the title more than Mama Harriet, deserving recognition among the greatest of mystics. This book endeavors to honor her with that distinction by focusing on her spiritual life and allowing her voice to speak afresh to those who may be enslaved by systems, cultures, and ideas today that create blocks and the inability to know and be true to the image bearers they were called to be. Harriet still has the power to lead us to freedom. Many books tell Harriet Tubman's story of enslavement, which led her to become a renowned conductor of the Underground Railroad, freeing many and never losing one. I lift up in this book what I believe is at the core of Harriet's being, the public mystic who found first her internal and emotional emancipation through her deep relationship with the divine. Some associate the word public with fame, intellect, or political acumen, but the term public mystic for Harriet and others speaks of those who embrace the idea in indigenous systems that to give to one's community is a public spiritual act. In this understanding, Mama Harriet is as much a public mystic as she is a female conductor on the Underground Railroad and a Union soldier, spy, and healer during the Civil War, finding opportunities to free relatives and others from chattel slavery. A woman of deep faith, deeply connected to her ancestors. No more than twice removed from the Africans brought through the Middle Passage, she embraced the mystical and the African indigenous belief that her gifts were for her communities. Her faith and mystical presence have been largely overlooked and are only whispered in some circles. I want to shout. Harriet Tubman was a public mystic and was deeply connected to her African indigenous roots. She was focused on her duty to give the enslaved within her reach, her family, and some others, the same chance of freedom she desired and attained, emotionally and spiritually, in the framework of African indigenous mysticism, which puts the social order at the forefront of divine concern. Nevertheless, their freedom was superficial. In terms of law, they remained the property of their enslavers, who sought to regain possession of them. Harriet's spirit is still at work, leading people like me, a spiritual director and emotional emancipation facilitator, and you, to freedom, adding to what Christian tradition calls a great cloud of witnesses. Hebrews chapter 12, verse 1. As a spiritual director and writer of Christian spirituality in the public mystic tradition, I am not writing as a historian or totally viewing Harriet from a historical perspective. My intention is to make visible the vital nature of African indigenous belief, which permeates the Christianity of the Black Church. Our sense of duty to our communities, our love and care for creation, our vital culture, our conviction that our gifts are for use in service of freedom and justice. I desire to expand our perspective of Harriet and others and to encourage through Harriet's story, my own, and the voices of other prominent public mystics, such as Thurman, that our emancipation is very much connected to our embrace of our origins. I cannot think of a more worthy example of a public mystic than Mama Harriet's life and works for freedom, both within and without. I invite you to join me in this exploration. Maybe you feel that there is still a part of you that remains in bondage to systems and structures and peoples. If so, follow me into these chapters, which tell the story of a small woman known as Harriet Tubman, who, while struggling with the effects of a brain injury, embraced the mystical, heard the sound of the genuine in herself, and led the way to freedom, first for herself, and then for an unknown number of others. In her moments of narcolepsy, Harriet would often have dreams or visions. When she recovered from her seizure, she would have premonitions to take her charges in a different direction to avoid capture. She never lost a passenger, she would say, on their treks to freedom. How does Harriet's story inform us of our present and future treks to freedom? Chapter 1. Understanding the Mystical Road to Freedom. I said to the Lord, I'm going to hold steady on to you, and I know you will see me through. Harriet Tubman, from Scenes in the Life of Harriet Tubman by Sarah Hopkins Bradford, Harriet Tubman Historical Society. Harriet Tubman, a public mystic, was a woman whose African ancestors traversed the Middle Passage into the Americas, where some were landed on the eastern shore of Maryland. There, Harriet Tubman was born Araminta Ross in Dorchester County around 1822. Araminta is a Hebrew baby name meaning lofty. As a child, Araminta was told she had the characteristics of the Ashanti of Ghana, but no records exist to prove her ancestry. Later in her life, she would remind many of those who sought her capture and those she guided to freedom of the biblical character Moses. Minty, as she was known until she came of age, sustained a major brain injury when she was about.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.